Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about acoustic alignment. My grandma used to have all, God bless her, she used to have all these. She lived to be, I think, 102. Married like 78 years. Crazy numbers, you know, but she used to have all these sayings. She'd watch the news and watch the behavior and watch the or listen to the language, and she'd always come up with, you know, people don't plan to fail, they fail to plan. She used to always say that, you know, and we've kind of adopted that here. And then the other one she used to say was, the elevator to success is out of order. You have to take the stairs one step at a time. And both of those statements are incredibly valuable when it comes to our thinking and our alignment in acoustics, because there's so many variables that we have to look at. I was looking at our checklist for new rooms the other day, and we're over 200 items that have to be checked off when the room is built and completed. Lots of crazy stuff, because our goal is resolution. And it takes a step-by-step approach to get to those goals. And we have, you know, the three resolutions that we've talked about there. First things, we must develop a sonic strategy. What are you trying to achieve with this room? Is it going to be a theater room for the family? Multiple people there? Is it going to be two-channel listening for yourself? On the flip side, or the professional side, are you going to make a living in this room? Are you going to mix? Are you going to master? Are you going to record live vocals? What are you going to do? What's the usage? So we've got to develop a strategy, and this strategy has many variables that contribute to it, see? And that's the step-by-step process that we have to go through. So strategies based upon experience, how many years you've been doing it, and the usage. The reason the experience is important is because you've learned the things that you don't want to have in your room. If you're an engineer, you've worked in other rooms, in other places. You don't want this in your room. You've heard it. You don't want it. So the experience really comes into play, and obviously the usage, what are you doing in the room, comes into play. Mastering engineer will have very different goals than a live recording engineer, even in the same space. So you have to define that. We have to determine a resolution goal, 70, 80, 90%. Those are the three that we work with. And that's the critical part, getting these numbers, getting the subjective turned into the objective. And that's a step-by-step process. Step-by-step to get to those three resolutions. Room size, volume must match the usage. We see this all the time as a problem. People are trying to do too much in too small of a space. There are acoustic breakpoints that restrict certain usages to certain room size and volumes. We've learned over the years that if you have this size room and you want to do this usage, you can't, because we can't treat our way out of the problems. And we can't get the resolution that your strategy demands. So we're beat before we start. So we have to stop. I tell people all the time to find another room. I have no problem doing that, because I know from past experience and from what they're telling me their strategy and goals are, we can't get there, even with our technology, especially in the low end, because ours is the most powerful. So if we can't get you there, nobody can. So let's be realistic about that and lower our expectations a little bit, or worst case scenario, get another room, right? So what do we have here? We have to select the dimensions that allow for the treatment to really work well. I was always told in practice through the years that if your speaker could handle 100 watts per channel, that your amplifier should be 200 watts, should always be twice what the maximum capability in terms of wattage that the speaker could manage. I don't know how that came about. I understand that more power, better transient coverage, and attack and decay maybe in the low end and all of those good things, but that was always the ratio we went by. So you want to make sure that the room dimensions, that when we add the treatment really can perform well within its margins. You'll just get more you'll get a better result with less surface area coverage. So the size of the room really helps us out a lot, and we have to take all that into consideration. So room strategy must include usage and amplitude. How much energy are we going to put in a room? If it's a live room, what instruments are going to be in it? Drums, they're the second largest producing, energy producing source of any instrument. A gong is first. So you got a huge energy source in a closet. That's what we see a lot. Can't have that. See, so because the bass, the kick drum, the tom and the snare don't have any room to breathe, so to speak. So you won't get good quality tone and sound. So what's our next step? Well, middle and high frequency reflection management. Reverb. So reflections interfere at the microphones if you're doing live. They interfere at the listening position if you're listening, mixing, and monitoring. That's why engineers sit near field to take the room out. So all that can be managed, okay? Absorption and diffusion to match the room size and usage. Diffusion is a great technology, but really misunderstood in terms of application and just it, how it works in theory. So the last item I want to stress here is we do have the technology to get these resolutions, but you have to be realistic. You have to be realistic about the space required, the materials and treatment to achieve the objective, but we can get there. We really have that ability. You know, we have the ability to manage the low frequency problems in any small room. Our new rooms, when we build new rooms from the ground up, plus or minus 2 dB from 30 to 16K, guaranteed. So we have the technology. No more mud and soup in the low end. Acoustic alignment. I just remember what my grandma used to say, you know, got a plan and you got to take it one step at a time. Hope this helps. Thank you.
Thank you for watching this video. And if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to. So please do that because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions and I usually get a chance every couple of days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis. So that'll help you. Thank you.